whole pathway. Now here we can work. Now this is for the researcher. We as doctors just have to find out if we can have some product available, which is FDA approved, even for the off-label use. If we can find out something. Limited capacity for evolution to act on the late reproductive life. Random cellular degeneration. So we are already working on this. Antioxidants. Mitochondrial dysfunction is more by the genetic counseling. Impaired autophagy, medicines are coming up for that. Impaired genome maintenance, again the gene therapy is going to work on it. Telomere shortening, lot of lifestyle changes in the medicine like TA65. There is one medicine by name of TA65 which has already been approved to act on the telomere. And again more advanced medicines will be coming soon. There is some extract of astragalus. Astragalus is an algae, yeah. It's an algae probably. It's an extract of that, TA65. It is already mentioned in our textbook now, sir. Altered gene expression, again, here, lifestyle changes and the gene therapy. What Dr. Mahajan says, like peptides will come someday. Macromolecules, micromolecules, and we are going to just act on the genetics of the patient. Here, grandmother effect, simple thing, let your mom stay with you. It will really prolong aging. Adaptive senectitude, understand this concept. So that you are not forcing a 70-year man who is just marginally overweight to lose weight. Simple, if you understand this concept, you will lose some business. I'm sure, but I think we are not here just to make money. Right? Money is just a medium to live. We in any case are going to make it. Immunosenescence, inflammation, aging, here comes the role of anti-inflammation. Detoxification protocols, everybody knows about them. Endocrine system, we know the endocrine change is happening in aging and then we try to take care of them either by supplementation, lifestyle, HRT, whatever. Vascular system, lot of things for that, prevention to cure. So statins, aspirin, chelation, detoxification, ECP, angiographies, angioplasties, whatnot. They all prolong aging and they are now the talk of the town. But only for longevity, not for wellness, believe me. So for SIRT, for mTOR, rapamycin is there. For sirtuin, resveratrol is there. Resveratrol, the grape seed extract, already proven to prolong aging. AMPK, something like metformin, and insulin pathway, insulin IGF-1 pathway. And this is all. So once we take care of these, so now understand that. How many things we have for anti-aging? It's not only hormones, what I do. Are doing just